Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to ASD App Store Domination. And today is the 20th day of your 30 days challenge. Good for you. Okay, today we are going to talk about how you can localize your bundle display name. So without further ado, let's get to work. Okay, we are going to localize our bundle display name, but what is the bundle display name anyway? So I will just show you my simulator here. And as you can see here, we have our calendar, photos, maps, and we have a little label beneath the icon. Now that is the bundle display name. Now, where can you set up your bundle display name? Now, I'll just open up Anti-Candy Crunch here and go to my project and select target and general. And you can set your bundle display name here under display name, Anti-Candy 11. And I believe here we have this anti-candy, but you see that it says anti-candy 11 here and it says anti-candy on the test device, and that is because I have localized it. And we are going to do that for our English version. As you can see, here it is anti-candy, and we are going to set it for our Hungarian version. So we are going to localize it. For that, we are going to create a new project and we will go from there. So let's just minimize this and let's create a new project here. And it will be a single view application. I will name this. And it will be a type language Swift. And let's create next. And let's just drop it onto the desktop. Okay, here it is. And as you can see, by default, our display name is derived from our bundle identifier. Okay, and I will just run this on my simulator here, and then I will just close it and let's see what that means, how this bundle display name is shown on our device. Okay. I believe that is running now, and I will just close it. And let me just open our simulator here. And as you can see, it says localize bundle and three dots because it's much too long for it to be shown on your device. So what I am going to do for a start, I am going to make this shorter. So let's say localize, and that's it, just localize. Well, a really good interpretation of the what your app is going to do. So I'm just build and run again. As you can see, it already changed to localize, and let's stop that so we may see it in detail. Here we have localize, but if we change to a different region or a different language for our phone, then it would still be localized because this is the base, let's say, localization of your app. What I really want to do now is create a localization for our app. And for that, first of all, let's go into our project. And let's add a localization. As you can see, English is our development language. And let's add here a Hungarian. Okay, and it asks us to localize the main storyboard and the launch screen. I'm already talking a lot about this inside the tribe. So go ahead and take a look at the tribe and subscribe at the special offer at rebeloper.com/the/tribe/black special offer. Go ahead and type that in. You will have a link also down below, and you can subscribe so you may see how I localize the main storyboard and the launch screen.storyboard. Of course, if you wish, let me just go back here, you can just take a look at the table of contents, and if I am correct, you can also take a look at a sneak peek, a look inside our localization. Well, I just couldn't find it. Go ahead and take a look at it and look inside any of the courses, the lessons. Okay, and let me just put this down and let's click on finish. And now we have added our Hungarian localization. Now, what we need to add now is a localizable info, well, an info plist localizable file. And for that, we are going to create a .strings file. So go ahead and right click here and let's create a new, and let's just scroll down till you find your strings file. Here it is. And let's click on the next here. And it is highly important that you name it info plist. So info plist with a capital I and a capital P. Okay, let's create it here. And here we are. We have our info plist. And now let's just localize it. And to do that, click on when just navigate to the file inspector. And here you have our, as you can see, a localization. So let's localize it. And the file will be moved into the APPRENTICE folder for the following language. Okay, let's localize it. Good. And now let's add Hungarian too. And as you can see, we now have two files, an English file and a Hungarian file. Okay. Now, what do you need to add here? And I'm just simply copy and paste this line of code here. Okay, from, I will just add it first for our English version. Okay. And it says CF bundle display name. And I will just name this. And let's just build and run and see if the changes have taken effect. Okay, let's stop this. And there you have it, localized now, because English is the base language. Now, let's do the same for our Hungarian info plist string. So I just copy this out. So let's change this to Hungarian. Okay, and now let's build and run again. And of course, because we haven't changed the device's language, we are not going to see any change. Localize now. So to do that, let's just go into settings, and you can do this on your device too. And I believe, let's just scroll down here. No, it is inside the general language and the region, iPhone language. And now let us just select, let's cancel this out, Hungarian. Okay, maybe add a language if you don't have it, and English, and let's search for it here, Hungarian. Okay, and let's click on done, and let's change to Hungarian. And this will take a while, but after that, we can see the localized bundle display name. Okay, and let's move out of here. We just swipe that up, and I believe if we are correct, if we just swipe to the our app, here we have it localized. Now it is already set into the Hungarian bundle display name. Okay, that's it for today. Now you know how you can localize your bundle display name the right way. Hope you enjoyed this lesson, and as usual, get to work, localize your bundle display names, and I will see you tomorrow in the next one. Good stuff! Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below, and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work!